Simulation is a powerful tool for engineers when they try to understand some dynamic systems. They usually model the systems and then they simulate it. A system is any set of connected objects which you want to study. So it could be a few electrical components, or it could be a mix of electrical and mechanical components. The simulation is a controllable experiment which we performed on the model of the system. So this is how usually the simulation is defined. Just briefly, what is a model? So model, when we say model, so model is an approximation of the system. Because most of the real life systems are so complex. So what we do, we model the system with approximate mathematical models and then we simulate it. But it doesn't mean that you need a lot of mathematical knowledge. In Scilab, we have a powerful simulator. Just like Simulink in MATLAB, we have Xcos in Scilab. It's a visual tool, so the modeling has been done inside the tool, so you don't have to have the mathematical knowledge of how to model a system. You can straight away use the blocks. So there are blocks for every component. For example, blocks for displaying the data, blocks for reading, writing the data. So all these blocks, they are called palettes. They are available in Xcos. You can use those blocks. In order to start Xcos, you write a command Xcos on the command prompt and enter, and it will open these windows for you. So you better just adjust these windows first so they don't overlap each other. Otherwise, when you go in one window, the other will be gone. These are the palettes. These are the blocks which are available in Xcos, which we can use for modeling. So there are a huge number of blocks available. As you can see on the left, this is the list of the palettes available. And in this first lesson, we will use only two or three types of elements. And there will be two sources which we will be using. And what are sources? Sources are from where we activate the blocks. For example, clocks. Clocks usually activate the scopes or the displays where we see the output of a system simulation. And similarly, the files from where we read the data. So similarly, the input ports. So all these type of things are in sources. So in sinks, you have displays and you can write data here. You can write data to, or you can say the output ports are also available. They are also in sinks. So output ports for writing data. So these type of things are available in these palettes. So explaining all this will take a lot of time, but there are little differences. For example, let's say that this is a single display scope. This is a multiple display scope. This is a floating point scope. So these are little differences in all these, but we will be only using this single scope, single display scope. From this sync section and from the sources section, we will use this clock. So currently we are not reading data from any files. We are not using any input ports from here. We only use this clock from here. And then we use from syncs, we use this display scope, single display scope. And one more thing we will be using from source is this step input. Like most of other courses, we will also start our first example from a step input to a first order control system. So for that, we will use this step and this clock, and that's from sync we use display, and then from the continuous time system, we will use this transfer function block. So these four things we will use in this first lesson, and we will only build a model of these. And in the next lesson, we will make the simulation, because in simulation, I have to explain certain other things. Otherwise, this video will be too long. So first of all, let's start from the transfer function block. So this is a transfer function block. So click on this and then you can drag it here in the working window. So just release the mouse button and it will be placed here. Now we go to sinks, and in sinks we need this single display scope, and we drag it and we put it in front of here. Don't worry about the alignment. We can align it very easily later on. Then from the sources, we have to put two things for this simulation, step input to the system. And I will explain you a little bit what is this step input and what is a first order system, because if you don't know anything about these, then it's harder to explain this simulation. So therefore, I will take a few minutes to explain this first order system. after I put all these blocks here, and then we will simulate in our next lesson. So now the last thing left is the clock. So we just put a clock here, and now we have to link all these components. So first, let me explain that these red type of connections, they are activation connections. It means that something is being activated from the other block. So in this case, this clock is activating our display, and these are the input output connections. So this is input connection to this transfer function block, and this is output connection to this transfer function block. Similarly, it's a single input display. So in order to connect, for example, let's start from the left side. When you hover your mouse over this, it will become green. Then you press the left mouse button and drag to the next connection, and when it becomes green, you release the button and it will be connected. Now you can click outside and it will be connected. And similarly, you hover over this, then click the button, drag to the next connection. When it becomes green, release the button. Similarly, do it here, and now these all are connected. Now we want to align these blocks. So the best way, instead of you just try to align this, and as you can see that it's hard to align, because even if I try aligning, it will be very hard for me to align. You can do it like this, but the best way to align, just select all these blocks, and while keeping your mouse on any of these dots, right click, and then into format, there is align blocks, and in align blocks, these are different alignments available. So as you can see that we want this type of alignment, the middle alignment, so that all blocks are horizontally in the middle, they are aligned. So you just click on this and the blocks will be aligned. Then you click somewhere else and it will, you are ready to simulate. Now you can start the simulation here, or you can change, or you can set the parameters of these components. So the parameters of these components can be set by going into, first click on the block you want to set, and in the simulation go to setup. In setup, when you go here, now you can set these parameters here. So for example, final integration time means how long you want the simulation to run, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, or 30 seconds. So you don't need to set any of these, but there are options available. For example, these are the solvers. These are the numerical methods which the software will use to solve this block. So there are different values available. You can try different, and if you want to go back to default, you can press the default. For example, you go here, you use the Ranjikuta method, and then you come here, then you want the default one, you just click default and it will be selected. Similarly, if you click on clock, go to simulation and setup, then you can set the parameters of this clock. In this way, you can set the parameters. So for example, here instead of this one and one, if you want to put some variable. So for example, instead of one, you want to put k in the numerator and some time in the denominator. First, you put this by editing these blocks. You put here in the numerator, you put k, for example, and in the denominator, you can put, instead of one, you can put t. And then after this, you can just go here, and by clicking on this, go here, set context, and then you can assign the values to those k and t, or whatever variables you are taking, you can assign values here. So in this way, you can do some parameter setting and some value assignment to variables in this working window. Before we start simulation, let me explain to you a little bit about what is this transfer function, and what should be the response when we connect these three scopes. What should we expect? What are we looking for here? So that I will explain now. So this is the transfer function of the system. Transfer function is the output of the system divided by the input of the system in S domain. So S is a complex number, and we cannot explain everything here, but let's say that this is the transfer function of your control system. So you have a numerator and you have a constant term. So this numerator, you can say it's a k, it's general form. In the general form, it's a k, or the gain of the system. And this constant term, you can say it's a a. So when we say step input, it means we commanded the system to go to the value equals to 1. It's a unit step, so 1. So system should follow our command, and system should start from 0 and it should reach the value of 1. because the system has some dynamics. So it cannot go straight away to one, like jump from 0 to 1. So system will follow a certain path and it will reach the position 1. So it will follow a curve. So if you draw a tangent at the point 0 of this curve, you will get the value of A. It is the reciprocal of the time constant, or it is also the initial slope of this curve. So this is the first order systems. First order system will go like this. The second order system will not go like this. And when we say the first order system and second order system, it means power of the S. If the maximum power of S is 1, it's a first order system. And what is the time constant? The time constant is the time in which the system reaches 63% of its final value. So the final value is 1. So the 63% of 1 is 0.63, and if you drop it like here, you will see that this is 0.5. 0.5 means 1 divided by 2. This is 2. So it means 1 divided by A. So that the constant, the time constant of the system is the time in which the system reaches 63% of its final value. And this parameter is very important, because if you know the transfer function of any system, you can apply control theory, and then you can say a lot about those systems. Your understanding of that system becomes almost complete if you know the transfer function of the system. But the problem is finding a transfer function is not always easy, because this transfer function comes from differential equations, and those differential equations are hard to make. So therefore, there is another technique that is called system identification. And in system identification, we analyze the system using this curve. If the system is following a curve which looks like a first order system, then we see, okay, this is the curve, and how can I get the value where the system is reaching 63% of the final value? So this is the time constant of the system. Then we get the A. Then we see the ratio of this K to A, which is the final value. The final value is 1, which is the ratio of this numerator to the constant term. K divided by A is 1. So then we can actually identify the system. We can identify means that we can get the transfer function of the system just by giving it a step input and looking at the response of the system. We can find the value of A, and we can find the value of K, and we can make this equation. We can make the transfer function equation, and this is very important. And this technique is called system identification. I'm not going into detail of system identification, but I'm just telling you that why this curve is so important. So now let's take another example where K is different than A. In this example, the transfer function is 6 divided by S plus 2. So now K is changed, K is 6, but A is still 2. Now the system's value, the final value, which is K divided by S, 6 divided by 2 is 3. Now the final value of the system is 3, and the time constant is still the same. This is the step response of this transfer function. I plotted it for a very longer time, as you can see, for 100 seconds, but then I zoomed it and I just cropped the image, and I cropped for only initial part of the image so that I can clearly show you. Otherwise, the curve will not be very prominent. So now let's say that we don't know anything. We don't know anything about this system. We only have this curve. So from this curve, we can find K and we can find A by looking at the 63% of the final value and the final value itself. We can find K and A, and hence we can find this equation, which is the transfer function of the system. And now in simulation, what we will do, we will take any transfer function, we will apply a step input, and we will get this response. This is what we will be doing in our simulation in the next video.